question?
Nine plus eight?
Because on the second step on the bottom, you did.
That's what?
Yeah, you added it, so 40 times something.
Four times what together?
Oh, wait. Why the one above it?
This one?
The one like you did 36 plus eight, since you're supposed to time every, times every for the other, and then add.
So you're asking if I should hold off on adding this until I multiply this?
Yes.
No. I don't have to. Could, but if I did, it wouldn't make any difference. Like if I didn't add these together, I left it as 36 plus 8, and then I multiplied the negative 3 times, or the negative 9 times the negative 3 and got 27.
Oh, wait.
I'd still have plus 36 plus 8, which would be the same as.
I still get negative 26.
You had negatives?
Yeah, because I forgot the, that this was a negative.
Cats?
Yeah.
They're impressive, aren't they?
Are you admiring his cats?
No, that was a connected buddy there.
Okay. Now, what we should have is you should have 70 when you put 7 there. We have 70 here. We should get 71. Yeah. 71. If we're not on the same page there, we should get there. Okay. Are there any disputes here? Anything we need to clear up? That's good. Okay. Isn't the same page, Molly?
Well, I wasn't really sure on how we were supposed to do this, so instead I just simplified the expression and then I plugged in what x equaled.
Mm-hmm.
But on the second one, I'm not getting 71. If I just simplified it and I plugged in 3 as x.
When you did this one, did you get 70?
Yep.
When you simplified it, what does it look like when you simplify it?
The same as
13x minus 21.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So my point here, my beginning point is that if we have an expression and it's simplified version, you may not have realized, maybe you did, but maybe you didn't. The simplified version just means it acts the exact same way, but it's simpler. Now, let's see. If I put like 7 in there, 7 in here, I've gotten 70 in both. What would you expect to happen? You don't need a specific number answer, but if I were to plug 5 in there and 5 in there, what do you think would happen in each case?
Turning to
50. You could be 50?
I'm
guessing. Like I said, I'm not looking for a specific number answer, I'm just asking like,
you think they'll be the same.
Yeah, we'll just get the same thing. Okay? So simplified version, when you plug whatever you wanted for x, it should give you the same thing you got when you plugged it in the same number here. Okay, plug in 5 here and 5 here, you should get the same thing. Plug in negative 12 here, negative 12 here, you should get the same thing. Okay. Otherwise, what use would the simplified version be if it behaved differently? Right. So why then would we call this the simplified version?
Because you can't break it down anymore.
It's as simple as possible. What is simpler about this as opposed to that, now that we've taken the time to plug 7 into this one and 7 into this one? What's simpler? Someone new? Yes?
Which one is simpler?
What would you say? Would you say that this is simpler or that this is simpler? Why is it simpler? Okay. And when I go to plug 7 into it, what's simpler about this? As opposed to plugging 7 in for x here. Anybody want to try to put into words, plugging 7 into this, or plugging 7 in for x here, which would be simpler? blank stares are not going to progress us forward very quickly. Yes, Kyle?
Is it the 13x minus 21?
And why would you say that that's simpler for plugging 7 into?
Because all you really have to do is 13 times 7 and then subtract 21 from that answer.
Right. Maybe we're all thinking it, but I am asking, so I'm expecting someone to say it. Now, Kyle has said it. All we have to do is multiply by 13 and subtract 21. Done. Over here, there's lots of multiplying, subtracting, lots of combining, lots of room for errors to happen, right? Losing track of negatives, maybe. Here, as long as we simplify correctly, much, much easier, less work.
So at first I simplified everything down and then I plugged in the 7 and I got 72 instead.
70?
Mm-hmm. And then these ones.
Oh, you got minus 19 instead of minus 21 because I think probably you did 20. Minus 1 is 19, call it minus 19. It's negative 20 minus another one.
Okay, sounds like you probably just didn't simplify this correctly.
Yeah,
you simplified it. It should look like
at
this.
At first I was doing it wrong, then I fixed it and I've looked it over a few times and I don't think I did anything wrong.
Well, if you simplified this and you didn't get 9x squared minus 6x plus 8 or negative 6x plus 9x squared plus 8 or something like that, then it's not simplified correctly, because this is simplified correctly. This is simplified form of this expression. Let's
where did the
simplify that together.
X squares come from?
Okay.
From that.
So let's see, we got 12x plus 8. I can't add 12x plus 8, right?
No.
They're not the same thing. I have negative 3x times parentheses negative 3x plus 6. How would I multiply that by the parentheses? Yeah? The distributive property, I'm going to take this whole thing, distribute it, both things. Negative 3x times negative 3x. Let's just write negative 3 times x times negative 3 times x plus negative 3 times x times 6 plus 12x plus 8. Does that make sense what I just did?
Yeah.
Okay. So negative 3x is the same as negative 3 times x, so I just kind of put a little dot there to signify that we're multiplying the x's. Negative 3x times negative 3x, okay, because the question was where did the x squared come from. I'm going to show you where the x squared came from. Let's see, 12x plus 8. Here, negative 3x times 6. What's negative 3x times 6?
It's negative 18x
plus 12x
plus
8.
Oh, wait, I see what I did wrong now.
Now over here, negative 3 times x times negative 3 times x. How about we just look at it like this? Negative 3 times negative 3 times x plus this negative 18x. Sim?
I have a question.
Uh-huh.
Where did that third negative 3x come from?
So I distributed this negative 3x first to this negative 3x. So it's negative 3x times negative 3x. That's what that is.
Yeah.
Distribute the negative 3x. You have to distribute it to both these things. So negative 3x times 6. There's negative 3x times 6.
Okay.
Wait, so Mr. Stewart.
So it's pretty much like negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Almost.
Almost.
It's
but
not almost
isn't
that.
The same.
Yeah, but it's like 9 times negative 3. I mean, negative 9 times negative 3. I mean,
where's negative 9 times negative 3 coming from?
Because you're getting... So, one second. so it's taking negative three times negative x, to get 9x.
Negative three times x is 9x?
No.
All I've done here is negative 3x times negative 3x. We're just multiplying a bunch of stuff together, so I'll multiply them together in this order. So negative 3 times negative 3 is 9.
Yeah. And then you would have to instead of times in the negative 3x plus 6, why don't you just subtract it? You get negative 3.
Are you talking about up here?
Yeah.
Negative 3x plus 6 is negative 3?
No, it's positive 3.
Negative 3x plus 6 is positive 3.
Yeah.
Negative 3x plus 6. The number 3?
No.
Is it 3x?
No.
It's not either one. It's not 3, and it's not 3x. This is some x's. And what is this? Six what?
Ones.
Good. Stuck with you from last class, right? So we have a bunch of x's, a bunch of ones, and that they're different things, so we can't put them together and say, oh, here's three of them. Does that make sense, Kyler? Okay, so you might have heard it called combining like terms. Those were not like terms. We cannot combine them because they're not the same thing. All right, but here we have negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. X times x would be the short way of saying x times itself.
X
times itself is the same as x?
X1, x squared.
Squared. What does 5 squared mean?
5 times 5.
5 times 5. So what does 5 times, what's the short way of saying 5 times 5?
5 squared.
5 squared. Well, here's x times x. What would be the short way of saying multiply x by itself?
X squared.
X squared, 9x squared. Molly?
How come you can't do just negative 3x times negative 3x equals 9x? Why do you have to change it to the negative 3 times x times x?
So, let me just repeat what I think you asked. Why can't you say negative 3x times negative 3x is 9x?
Yeah.
Well, let me just say it this way. You could say negative 3x times negative 3x, jump all the way through all those steps, and say 9x squared, because that's what it is.
Okay, but like when you add, you're not going to do that in this, but let's say that it was 9x, and you're going to add the 12x, you would just do,
because of all of this is the answer to your question. Because what we're doing is distributing the negative 3x to both of these terms. Distribute the negative 3x to a negative 3x. What we wind up with is a negative 3 times an x, because that's what negative 3x means. Negative 3 times an x times another negative 3 times an x. And you have to kind of like put that all together, figure that all out. Well, we're just multiplying four things together. When I multiply, I can multiply in any order I want. So I'll multiply the negative 3 by the negative 3. That's positive 9. And there's two x's being multiplied together. So an x times an x, we can write as x squared. It would just be 9x.
But with the 9x plus 12x, you could change it to 9 times x plus 12 times x. Then you wouldn't be able to take that x and times it by the other x, and then... Oh, wait. No, that doesn't make sense. No, it doesn't make sense. But you, if you were to do that, if you were to switch, if you were to write, 9 times x plus 12 times x, and then you were to move the numbers and you did 9 plus 12 times x, that wouldn't...
So 9... Help me write down what you're saying. You're saying
so
9
times x.
9x.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Plus 12x. So you like when you did the negative 3x is the same as negative 3 times x. You could do 9 times x and 12 times x. And like you did there, you would move the x's together. So like I don't understand how with you're adding the 9x and 12x is 21x, and you just add the numbers together, and then it's x afterwards. But with that, the you have to do the x's as well.
Well, I mean, the simple difference is that we're adding these, but we're multiplying these.
Yeah, well, why do you have to have the x involved? With the other one, you're just doing the numbers, and then you put x at the end.
Well... Here what we're doing is we're taking 9x's, which is, in its longest form possible, 9x's added together. There's 6 of them. Okay, there's 9 of them. Here's 12 of them. Indeed, there are so many x's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12. Now here's the key part. There's 9x's there and there's 12x's there. And what we're doing with all of these x's is we're adding them together. So now we can see it's just a string of added together x's.
Yeah, I think
we have 21x. When we multiply, when we take an x times an x, we get like kind of a whole new thing.
Okay.
We get an x squared.
Yeah, I understand. I was thinking that they were like, you do it the same way, but yeah, I understand.
I think that's what you're saying. I hope that does clear it up, because here we're just collecting x's together, and so I just kind of sweep them into a big dustpan, and we got 21 of them. But here, we multiply them together, we get a new thing, an x times an x, which is an x squared.
Okay, yeah.
So,
I understand now.
Yeah.
I'll stop asking the
question. No, it's a good question. I'm sure you're not the first person to get confused by that. So. 9x squared, that's where the x squared comes from, because at some point an x got multiplied by another x, which is kind of new. Like, we haven't seen that, at least in this class, very many times. So then we have minus, oh, here's a negative 18x and a positive 12x. So we can put those together, and we have a negative 6x. And then there's the plus 8. Turns out, like, this 8 that was there, those 8 ones, there were no other ones to combine together with those 8 ones, and so that's all we ever had. There was no terms to go along with this constant. It just kind of came through without being combined to anything else. So we simplified it. There it is, simplified version. And now you see we get an x squared. All right, so now let's take your homework. You did the first 8, correct?
Yeah.
Alright, so take a look at the first 8. There are the answers. The 6 plus 3 times negative 5x minus 4 minus 8x plus 10. Alright? Should I do 6 plus 3 is 9?
No.
Why not?
Because
that's not multiplying first. Listen. Everybody listening?
Yeah.
The reason, it is an order of operations thing, the reason I don't add these first is because this 3 is multiplied. It doesn't have anything to do with this parentheses. If it was multiplied by 7, we multiply by 7. If it was multiplied by octopus, we multiply by octopus. Whatever's there, we're multiplying it by that before we add 6.
No, it's octopi.
Not 3 octopi, I'm saying 3 times
it's
an octopus.
One octopus.
That makes
no,
sense.
Octopus.
Those are
3
octopi.
Three.
Explain
that
to
you.
Wait, what if they made octopus pie?
And
you
called octopi.
They do.
Are we ready?
that would be good.
Longer this takes, the more homework you have. Not because I'm punishing you, but because we had less time to do it in class. So, 3 is being multiplied by, it doesn't matter what it's being multiplied by, it should not be added to 6 before we multiply it by this other stuff, because that's the order that we use. So, let's do that. How do I multiply a 3 by a parenthesis, now that we are seeing that it is parentheses? Shout it out.
Distributive
property. 3 times negative 5x is negative 15x. 3 times negative 4 is negative 12 minus 8x plus 10. All right, let's see. Negative 15x minus 8x, negative 23x. 6 minus 12 is negative 6. Plus 10, it's positive 4. Negative 23x plus 4. Yeah.
Didn't you want us to like put instead of negative 5x minus 4, do negative 5x plus negative 4?
When I do that, when I say plus negative 4, I'm trying to help you see something. It's not necessary that you do it every time you see a negative.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
So no, we don't need to do that. If we did though, it would be exactly the same thing. Then we would have a plus a negative 12, which is the same as minus 12. All right, so that was 3, now 4. Okay, here, should I do negative 3x minus 4x is negative 7x?
No.
No, because, and not just the x, but this whole thing
negative
is being multiplied by this thing.
Yeah. Gotta make sure you have the negative x.
Make sure you do have the negative there. Okay. Before that, though, it'd probably be easier if we went ahead and said 8 minus 3 is 5 plus 9. We're multiplying negative 4x by 5, negative 20x, negative 3x minus 20x, those are x's, they're like terms, so we can collect them together and say they're the total of negative 23x, plus 9, 5, 3 plus 2 times 12x plus 2 minus 5x. Can I do that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Could I have done something differently?
No.
Maybe. What about if I did this? 12x minus 5x is 7x. Can I do that?
Yeah. No.
I don't even know how.
Why can't we do that?
Because you have a 2 in the middle of it.
If you do it after.
Yeah.
No.
Let's see, let's compare.
But what's the answer? 7 plus 4.
Do it two different ways?
14 times plus 7. You know when it comes to math.
I know. I'm still wondering how I got it.
3 plus 24x plus 4 minus 10x. Can I put this 24x together with this negative 10x?
Yes.
So I get 14x?
No.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And 3 plus 4? Let's come over here. What would we do next?
2 times 7x.
3 plus 14x plus 4.
Yep.
14x plus 7.
Yes.
So inside the parentheses, there's some x's, and I combine the x's together. Just like in this step, I did 24x minus 10x is 14x. Just those x terms are similar. They're like terms. So I put them together. I can put these together inside the parentheses, then distribute. I can distribute first and then combine like terms. That's 5. gonna do this two different ways. Question? Or suggestion? Okay, go. Okay, so still inside the parentheses, we're just multiplying 6 through here, we get 4x minus 6 minus 2x plus 12. Okay, so you distribute there, and to there, and there. Four places. So we get 7 times 24 is?
126.
168.
I don't think so.
168?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I got 168.
So 168x minus 42 minus 14x plus
84. Yep.
Okay.
How did you get 42?
7 times negative 6.
Oh, maybe that's what I forgot.
168x minus 14x is 154x. Negative 42 plus 84. 42.
That's really wrong.
I could have chosen, instead of distributing the 7 to 4 different things, all the foot tapping and whispering to each other is distracting. I could have combined the 24x and the negative 2x before distributing. You got 22x. And negative 6 plus 12 is positive 6. Right? Then I would have had 7 times 22x plus 6, which would have just gone straight to 154x plus 42. That's a way. Here's another way. I could take, start over here. Here is a term. Negative 2x is another term. A positive 12 is another term. So I could just distribute the 7 to all three of these. I'll start over here on the right. 7 times 12, 84. 7 times negative 2x is negative 14x. Negative 14x plus 84. I'm going to take 7 and multiply it by this. Let's just write that the long way and see what happens. 7 times 6 times 4x minus 1.
Whoa.
24x. Sorry. If I multiply from left to right, I would multiply 7 times x, or sorry, 7 times 6, 42 times 4x minus 1, minus 14x, plus 84. What's that? 168x minus 42 minus 14x plus 84 and 154x plus 42. All those orders are valid. Next, number 8. 9x squared plus 8x minus 2, whoa, minus 4x squared minus 2x plus 7.
You really don't even need to solve this one out. You can just take negative 4x squared minus 9x and you get 5x squared.
9x squared minus 4x squared is 5x squared.
Yeah, and then just then minus 2x to 8x.
8x minus 2x is 6x.
Yeah, and then just add the 7.
Then we're done.
Are we going to go over the rest tomorrow?
I'm going to show you an example of one of the last few.
Is
that zipping
more?
Up?
Is there one more? The rest of them?
Will be. Wouldn't have been if we hadn't.
That's
been
easy.
So long.
Oh, I thought it was supposed to be
long. Let's take a simple example like 9.
Oh, 9 really?
We're gonna wind up staying past the bell if we can't stop talking.
You do nine.
This is nine.
Okay,
hold on. We distribute the x to the x and to the 1. And we talked about this earlier. What is x times x?
X squared.
X squared. X times x, like by definition, is x squared. X times 1?
X.
X. And there's a minus x. Anything to simplify here?
No.
Yeah.
Like what?
X minus x.
Is? It's nothing.
It's x2.
No. X, not 2. There's no such thing as an x2. X squared or x to the power of 2 means x times x, not x minus x. X times x. So complete the last 4 for homework. Have that ready next time. Not leaving yet. The battle's not over.